explore the concept of circumference. Now, in previous sections, we talked about perimeter. We found perimeters of different shapes. We found perimeters of triangles, of rectangles. And we found those by simply adding up the distance of all sides. Well, what if we have a circle? A circle technically only has one side. Or you can think of it as having infinite sides because it's round. It's not something we can measure this and measure that. We have to find the distance all the way around to find the perimeter of a circle. Well, we have to define some terms before we can actually find the distance around a circle. The distance around a circle is called the circumference. So the first thing we're going to define is the radius. The radius is defined as the distance from the center of the circle, it has to be the exact center, to any edge of the circle. So this value is the radius. And we usually label it a lowercase r. So if I measured from here to the edge, it's going to be some distance r. If I measure from here to the edge, it's some distance r, because circles are perfectly round as long as we're coming from the center. The diameter is defined as the distance across a circle. And you have to pass through the center. It's the widest point of the circle. So I could measure it this way, and I'd get some value that is the diameter. And we usually use a lowercase d to denote that. Or if I measured it this way, I'd get the same distance, because it should be a perfect circle. So radius is the distance from the center to the edge. And diameter is defined as the distance across a circle. Now, circumference, we have a formula. And if you remember when we talked about perimeter, maybe it was 2L plus 2W to find the distance of the perimeter of a rectangle, the distance all the way around. Well, for the circumference of a circle, we have a formula called 2 pi r. So 2 times the radius times pi. Now, pi is just a symbol we use to represent what we define as an irrational number, which means that it doesn't terminate in its decimal. And since we're introducing decimals here, we have to introduce numbers like this. This is pi. Pi is 3.14159265.4. And that actually would continue. So I put these ellipses to denote that number continues on and on and on forever. It never ends. It doesn't terminate. So if this is pi, we can use that to find this circumference. 2 pi times the radius. Now, the reason why I define diameter as well is because I want you to understand that there's a relationship between these. Radius being the distance from the center to the edge, and diameter being the distance across, diameter is equal to, our diameter is equal to 2r. 2 times the radius, because it's twice as much, this side and that side. So this formula, you can memorize it in terms of radius, but you can also memorize it in terms of diameter, because 2 times the radius is the diameter. So these are equivalent. As long as you know this relationship, that the diameter is twice the radius, you can use either one of these formulas, depending on what information you may be given. So let's take a look at an example here. It says the radius of the Ferris wheel at Navy Pier is about 75 feet. Find the circumference. Well, if we read it again, we're told something about the radius. So I'm going to write down r. And we're told that that's 75 feet. So the radius is 75 feet. And then we're asked to find the circumference. Well, that's where I need the formula. Well, which version of it am I going to use? The one that has radius or the one that has diameter? Well, the information I was given is the radius. So I'm going to use this one. Circumference is 2 pi times r. So now, all we have to do is do a little substitution. If r is 75 feet, let's evaluate this to find that circumference. 2 pi times 75. Now, because pi is that irrational number, we have to round it at some point. And it tells us here to use pi approximated to two decimals, 3.14. So 2 times 3.14 times 75. So I'm going to allow you to work on that math yourself. It's good practice for the examples we looked at. So go ahead and try that. And thank you for watching.